concentrating on a topic called a deadlock. So here the first introduction to deadlock I'll be giving with the help of a presentation. So I'll be explaining to the students and they have to listen that, and the main thing is they'll understand from the PPT explanation as well as their linguistic competency will be developed. And after that I'm telling or I'm making the students to role play that. Once I'm explaining the deadlock, now they have to think a different examples. How exactly, in what situation it can occur. It may be like real-time example or it may be anything. So I'm making the students to think about the real-time example and they have to role-play that and they have to show it to me. Then after that, again, the next topic I'm explaining by myself with the help of a PPT. Then, after that, once I explain, I've gone through the topic for a brainstorm what I'm doing here. So once the problem occurs, how exactly you're going to detect that problem? That mainly thing I'm doing, or I'm taking a methodology of a brainstorming so that I'll get a different answer from a different students. So finally I'll come to a conclusion and I'll just tell that conclusion how exactly you can detect the deadlock. Then afterwards, the deadlock prevention, they are demonstrating, the students, I'm telling them to demonstrate how exactly it will occur and guiding them. So in that, they can improve the spatial as well as the interpersonal competency will be developed among the students. Then again, the last part, how exactly you can recover from that I'm explaining with the help of the chart and board. Finally, once the entire thing is completed, they will be summarizing by giving the quiz. So I'm organizing the quiz, then after that finally I'm concluding what is the correct answer, what is the wrong answer. So exact the conclusion I'm doing at the end. So this is about all the three consecutive session plans, and this is what the two-day session plan, what exactly we are going to discuss. Now coming to the introduction, see, when you talk about a deadlock, see, usually we'll say that like it's a multi-programming environment or it is a multi-processing environment. What is meant by that? What is meant by multi-programming environment?
Many processors
can execute at a time. Whenever the number of processors they are executing at a time, they may compete for the resource. So that time you have to allocate a resource such a way that there should be no deadlock. Sometimes what happens, one processor will be waiting for the particular resource, but that resource may be held by some other process. So I have to wait until the particular process releases that resource. So that is what the deadlock. So here, that's what, whenever the different processes, they compete for the resources, the main chances of happening a deadlock. So here, these are the main four conditions where exactly the deadlock can occur. So the number one is a mutual exclusion. So when you talk about this, like the resources, it may be any number of resources. So either we may make the resources a shareable or we may make the resources a non-shareable. So when you are talking about a non-shareable resource, it indicates that when one process is using that resource, the other process has to wait until that completes. That is what the mutual exclusion. And the second point is hold and wait. So when one process is holding something, then only it is requesting for the other thing. So that is, it is holding on one request, one resource, and waiting for the other resource to come to it. And the third one is no preemption. That is, once the resources are allocated to a processor, they cannot be preempted. In the sense, they are not voluntarily leaving off the resources until their work is finished. And the last is the circular wait. So here, when you are talking about a set of processes, all will be waiting in a circular order for the other to complete. So these are the four necessary conditions for the deadlock to occur. And this thing, that is resource allocation graph, we can mainly see, or we can describe this deadlock over exactly with the help of a graph. So here you can see a cycle, right? See, there is from R2 to P1, then P1 to R, again there is a cycle here. So here it indicates that here one cycle and here one cycle. So that means the deadlock is occurring here. So whenever I say here, see, the P1 is requesting for a resource R1, but the R1 is already issued to P2. Now the P2 is requesting for R2. R2 is already issued to P1. So in this case, the deadlock occurs. How exactly you can avoid this? Whenever we say there are no cycles that we can say the deadlock doesn't exist. So we are going to demonstrate these things with the help of a little bit demonstration among all our team members.
See, now every one of you has seen this simple demonstration. Even these five philosophers want to eat something. They have observed something deficient. That is there, the resources are not available properly. So, there is no one want to share the resources. So, at that time, the deadlock is occurred. So, there is another process that can be held. They can read, they can think, they can write something. So, that time, what they did is, the two philosophers, all the philosophers stopped at a time, and they started doing, taking some notes writing, something like thinking. So at that time, resources are all available. The two processes, the two professors have started doing the process of eating. So that time, the three remaining professors, they are in the process of thinking something, eating something. So here, once they stopped eating, then the other professor started eating. So the resources are shared and the processes are shared to do some other process. This is how we can prevent that's deadlocking. So, what I conclude from this one is, instead of going to a situation of deadlock and going to the process of prevention, using and all these things, better we use the process of avoiding the deadlock using some algorithms like bankers algorithms and some safety algorithms. That's it.
Here I can show you some pictures where exactly you can see the real time how exactly the deadlock can occur. See here, this is a heavy traffic jam. So all the like cars, bus, everything, they have stuck, like no way to go. So this is what the deadlock condition. So in the other picture, if you go, so here, what is this? Can anybody tell? What might be this? What is happening here? Yes. Dogs. What they are doing?
Walking. Two dogs are walking.
Yeah, walking. So, no way to come out of that. That is what? The deadlock. What is happening here?
Traffic is jammed.
Due to, see, some cars are going this way, some cars are this way. All the four ways it is blocked. So, this is what? The deadlock condition. See, the other picture you can see. Yes. Can anybody tell this? What is this? What is happening here? That bird, it has taken into mouth, now it is not able to come out of that. So this is what a deadlock. So here, deadlock, it is nothing but it is a state where exactly it is not possible to come out. But there are so many methods of handling it. Either you can ignore that, you can say that nothing has happened, or you can go for a prevention method. That is, I told about the four necessary conditions. In order to prevent the deadlock, what you can do? You can make any of the condition should not work. That is, you can make either the resources a shareable, like as in this case. Here, once you are making a resource shareable, now everybody will get a chance to eat. So, he can finish his food. Or, voluntarily, you make one of the philosopher to leave the chopstick, so the other can get. So by doing these methods or by making any of the necessary condition not true or not happen, you can prevent the deadlock. And when you are talking about the avoiding a deadlock, So here always we should make sure that before entering or the deadlock should not occur. So what we can do for that? We have to first mainly concentrate on how exactly the resources are allocated between the processes. And we should know that, like, in the priority wise, which resource should be allocated to which process. And always make sure that we should be in a safe state. So whenever the process is going to an unsafe state, that means the deadlock is going to occur. So always properly issue or request the resource properly and give the resource to the process properly. So the final conclusion I can give, always don't prevent the deadlock. You have to avoid the deadlock.